As president, Donald Trump has access to America's most sensitive secret intelligence. And while he may not always believe all the intelligence he is given, he's not afraid to talk about getting it.
You know, sometimes intelligence is good, and sometimes you look at Comey, and you look at Brennan, and you look at Clapper, and right. I'm supposed to believe that intelligence. I never believe that intelligence.
But analysts say in an interview on Sunday, the president may have done more than just talk about receiving U.S. intelligence. He may have revealed it. Asked about a report that he personally authorized a U.S. cyber attack on Russian entities around the time of the 2018 midterm elections, Trump appeared to confirm the story.
I'd rather not say that, but you can believe that the whole thing happened, and it happened during my administration.
But why don't you talk about that?
Because they don't like me to talk. Intelligence says, please don't talk intelligence.
But that wasn't the only piece of intelligence President Trump might have revealed during that interview. While bragging about his negotiating skills, the president also appeared to give up sensitive details about why he didn't strike a nuclear weapons deal with Kim Jong-un at their February summit in Hanoi.
I said, look, you're not ready for a deal, because he wanted to get rid of one or two sites, but he has five sites. I said, what about the other three sites? That's no good.
Does Kim Jong-un have five major sites that produce nuclear weapons or the components for them? U.S. intelligence isn't saying tonight. We asked experts who track North Korea's nuclear weapons program. They say they had never heard the regime has five nuclear sites.
I could not tell you what those five would be. I don't know what President Trump had in mind there exactly.
Whether Kim actually has five nuclear sites isn't clear. The president could have been referring to something else. But one former CIA analyst says tipping off a dictator, then a TV audience, about anything the U.S. knows could be harmful.
If you show a country, we have all your satellite photos, this is you're building these facilities, they'll say, thanks for that information. We're going to try a little bit harder, make it a little tougher for you to figure that out again the next time.
Trump has talked about sensitive intelligence before at inopportune moments. In May of 2017, the president was criticized for inviting top Russian officials into the Oval Office and then allegedly telling them about intelligence the U.S. got from another country about ISIS plots. Trump defended his comments, but gave away even more information with his answer.
Just so you understand, I never mentioned the word or the name Israel.
But just weeks before that incident, in a phone call with the president of the Philippines, Trump divulged that two U.S. nuclear submarines were near the Korean Peninsula, according to a Philippines government transcript of the conversation leaked to The Intercept. Former spies say the president's tendency to brag about his intelligence could make U.S. officials, as well as overseas partners, reluctant to share important secrets with him.
If the next time you have something you'd like to keep secret, you may want to obfuscate that information. Another problem is other intelligence agencies, other countries will not be as interested or willing to provide this information the next time.
Tonight, neither U.S. intelligence agencies nor the White House are commenting on the president's remarks on intelligence or on the fallout that could bring. Former spies say that fallout could go all sorts of different ways, including if intelligence officials do not trust the president to keep sensitive secrets, and if they keep details from him, that could lead to catastrophic results when he goes into negotiations with someone like Kim Jong-un. President Trump might not have the information or the leverage that he would need.